LG clearly had big, big plans for its new flagship phone. And indeed, the G5 is packed with innovation, but there's just one problem. Some of the G5's riskier design decisions just don't pan out. So let's start with the new microdized aluminum unibody. At first glance, it looks pretty good with an almost glowing satiny luster. It's an improvement over last year's G4 model, which had a plastic back panel. However, the surface is prone to scuffs and scratches, and the body lines are somewhat marred by the so-called chin at the bottom of the phone. You pop off this piece to get to LG's battery, and the result is a disconcerting seam that leaves a gap where the two pieces connect. But hey, if nothing else, LG's battery swapping system is much better than before. To swap a depleted battery for a fully charged battery, you power down the phone, press a button, wiggle out the battery cartridge, and then sort of snap the battery off the chin. It sounds complicated, but it's actually easier than LG's previous battery swapping method, and that's important because the G5 didn't fare very well during our battery tests. The phone's 2800 milliamp hour battery has to drive a 5.3-inch display with a pixel density of an insane 554 pixels per inch. The screen looks gorgeous in full color, but LG's new always-on mode is way, way too dim when the G5 is asleep. You can't even see it here. Now, on the plus side, LG uses the latest, greatest processor and has finally given its flagship phone a fingerprint sensor. It's somewhat small and it sits on the back of the case, but I found it to be fast and accurate during testing. Now, just don't be alarmed when you unlock your G5 and see that LG has removed your app drawer from the bottom of your home screen. It's an almost inexplicable design decision. But then again, there's a lot about the G5's design that just doesn't make sense. Just know that you can get your app drawer back by downloading LG's Home 4.0 launcher and then choosing that theme from your settings menu. The G5 employs the same wonderful 16-megapixel rear camera found in the G4. Its accompanying software package comes with a full suite of manual controls that give the phone much of the functionality of a DSLR. It really is a killer camera. Unfortunately, I cannot say the same thing for the second rear camera that shoots wide-angle shots with a field of view of up to 135 degrees. Now, this second rear camera doesn't hurt, mind you, but how often are you really going to use it? Especially because it introduces distortion on the edges of the frame. So are you picking up on a theme here? For every solid feature in the G5, LG introduces another feature that makes you wonder, well, wait a second, what were they thinking? And nowhere is this more apparent than in the Cam Plus accessory that snaps directly into the G5's chassis. The idea is to give you a comfortable grip for shooting photos, as well as physical controls for turning on the camera, shooting stills and video, and controlling the zoom. The Cam Plus adds 1200 milliamp hours of extra battery power, but it makes the G5 way too bulky. And maybe even worse, I didn't find the physical camera controls to be very useful. In particular, the wheel for controlling zoom lacks resistance. It's actually sort of difficult to use. Okay, if you put aside all of the G5's ostensible innovations, it's really not a bad phone. And if a swappable battery is essential to your lifestyle, you can be confident that LG has got you covered. Just don't expect a sublime, elegant smartphone experience from top to bottom.